Good morning, this is Mission Control, Houston. Welcome and thank you for joining us for today's edition of ISS Update this Tuesday, September 18. We're now getting a live view inside the International Space Station Flight Control Room, where the team has been monitoring the systems aboard the station and supporting the day's activities of the Expedition 33 crew members. Leading the Orbit 2 team here in the Station Flight Control Room today is Flight Director Tony Sakachi. He's just entering the room now here in the center, about to take seat at his console. Now aboard the International Space Station, a three-member crew at the helm. As commander of the complex is NASA astronaut Sunny Williams, with flight engineers Russian cosmonaut Yuri Malenchenko and Japanese astronaut Aki Hoshide, who will work aboard the station as a three-member crew until the arrival of three new crew members in mid to late October. Malenchenko, Williams, and Hoshide arrived at the International Space Station after docking their Soyuz spacecraft TMA-05M to the Rosviat module on July 16. Today they will complete 66 days in space. Space Station, with its crew aboard, is now flying at an altitude of a little more than 260 statute miles. The orbiting facility is on a southeastern track. He's just about to make a turn to for a northeastern track, just coming across the southern ocean, and has just made its way toward an orbital sunset. We'll be passing across Australia soon, in about 15 minutes. The Expedition 33 crew kicked off its day with the first of two daily planning conferences with ground controllers around the world to review the day's activities and plan for the next set of tasks. Today, the station crew has another light day of duty coming after the recent departure of their previous Expedition 32 crewmates on Sunday. After some morning work prep and the first of her daily two-hour exercise sessions using the treadmill, Commander Williams turned her attention to science. Williams spent a couple hours this morning working on research known as the Reversible Figures Experiment that studies whether the perception of a figure that can normally be seen to change in perspective or orientation in two different ways is affected by microgravity. Williams also is activating and checking out the Erasmus recording binocular in the Columbus module, be performing some medical experiments, and will install the replacement desiccant packs into the Merlin, or the microgravity experiment research locker. Also today, Williams and flight engineer Aki Hoshide are participating in an onboard training session in advance of next month's capture and berthing of the second Dragon spacecraft to arrive at the space station. The duo will follow their onboard training session, reviewing rendezvous procedures with a conference with ground controllers. Hoshide took closeout photos of the docked automated transfer vehicle 3, or Eduardo Omaldi, which arrived earlier this year in March, bringing with its station and crew supplies, now filled with trash and unneeded items and packed for its disposal after it undocks from the space station next week on September 25. Hoshide also activated the low-flow fluid transfer pump to transfer fluid to wastewater bus, performed maintenance on the waste and hygiene compartment shown here, and will analyze water from the environmental health system using the total organic carbon analyzer, or the water recovery system. And in the Russian side of the house, with two of his cosmonaut crewmates now back on Earth, Malenchenko spent this morning with some housekeeping items as well as performed regular maintenance to the SOGE system. This is the Russian life support system. He's also downloading external temperature and pressure sensor data as part of a Russian science payload known as Identification that studies the station's dynamic loads during events such as dockings and reboosts. And each of the crew members will put in their daily 2 hours of exercise using the onboard gym equipment that includes a station bicycle, a treadmill, and an advanced resistive exercise device that simulates weightlifting here on Earth. The crew will then wrap the day with a final daily planning conference with the ground. and is scheduled to go to bed at 4:30 p.m. Central Time. This is Mission Control Houston.